You're listening to Work It Mommy, where the goal is to be the best mom ever, and most importantly, stay sane while you do it. So today I want to talk about cereals. In this podcast, on this episode, I'm going to talk about four that I think it is probably a pretty good idea to stay away from. And the reason I say that is because, you know, as moms, we want the best for our kids. Breakfast time is an important time of the day. They're starting out the day, and we want to make sure that we're giving our kids that morning boost in the healthiest way possible. Although at the same time, mornings are busy, and it's not easy to, you know, come up with a healthy solution for our kids in the morning. So I did want to go ahead and put this list of four out there because I feel that at least it gives you some to maybe knock off your list. And it's a good talking point for us to kind of address some issues that are problems with the kids' cereals that we have on the shelves today. And hopefully things will change with the cereals. But anyway, let me go ahead and get right into it. So first one I want to talk about is Kellogg's Honey Smacks. Okay, so it is 55.6% sugar. Yikes. Second one is Captain Crunch. That's another popular one. So many people grew up on Captain Crunch and probably have come accustomed to, you know, liking the taste of it and everything, but that's a lot of sugar. Kellogg's Fruit Loops, okay? That was one I have vivid memories of having as a child, unfortunately. And, you know, we can't be upset about this stuff, guys, because, you know, it just a couple, you know, decades ago, the information that we have on nutrition just wasn't available. Moms were really making the best choices that they could, you know, and they didn't know some of these things. So, you know, this isn't anything upsetting. It's just is what it is. But I do feel that today's mom, we are much more aware of, you know, diet and what's healthy and what's not. And I think we definitely have a responsibility as mothers to go ahead and give our children the best that we can, the best to our ability, since we do have this knowledge. So next one on the list, and this is one that I really liked when I started to get a little bit older, like an older kid, I can remember eating this cereal, and that is Cinnamon Toast Crunch. So that's actually 46% sugar. I was actually surprised that one didn't score even higher on the list as far as percentage of sugar, because it's got like straight up sugar just chilling all on the top of the little, you know, squares, puff squares, or whatever you want to call it. Anyway, it's mess. And I'm really sorry to the, you know, big brands that I am slamming today, but I do feel that more healthier options should be available. People should have the right to have the sugary cereals if they want them, I guess. But at the same time, I do feel that, you know, making more healthy options, it's better for everyone. And let's face it, sugar is addictive. And if you want to make those sales, unfortunately, I do feel that some of these bigger brands put the high sugar content in the cereals and the things that the kids are going to consume, because they know it does have that little bit of addictive property to it. And then when we bring them into the store with us, they're going to yell and scream until we buy the cereal for them that tastes good to them. So, but again, remember, it's our choice of what we introduce to our children. We don't have to introduce these cereals to our kids. As a matter of fact, my children have not had a single one of the cereals on this list, and they won't until they become almost adults, basically, and they choose if that's the life that they choose for themselves. But I had to make a conscious effort when I first started out as a mom. Like, you know, I can remember my first, you know, kind of when she was transitioning from like the baby oatmeal to cereal, I was like, okay, what cereals do I want her to eat? And, you know, why do I want her to eat these? You know, so definitely something to consider. Now, I want to share some more in-depth information on these brands besides just the sugar content, because you hear, okay, you know, Captain Crunch, you know, has 46.9% sugar content in it. So what? So what's the big deal with that? Okay, let's kind of really get some meat to this topic, because I do want you to walk away feeling informed and feeling like this is something that you should possibly consider for the health of your children. I care about my children, but I also care about other people's children too. So hopefully this information is helpful for you. So according to nutritional value labels, these cereals all have about 12 grams of added sugar per serving. Okay, so let me pause there. So what does the term added sugar mean? Okay, so when the term added sugar is used in nutritional verbiage, that means added sugar to a processed food, in particular, white sugar, okay? That doesn't account for the already naturally occurring sugar. So for example, a lot of these cereals are corn, rice, or oat based. And as you know, corn, rice, and oats, they already have their natural sugars that already exist in that particular thing. And the corn and the rice, those all have, you know, a little bit of natural sugars to them. So the nutritional label only accounts for the added sugar, okay? So you're getting 12 grams of added sugar plus the sugar that's already in it naturally occurring, okay? So you're already getting a lot of sugar there, okay? Another thing to consider that the problem is with added sugar is that it's always hard for the body to process because, you know, in the case of these cereals, they all have a low fiber content. So our bodies, the way it is designed is, you know, you need, you know, fiber to process sugar. So taking in high amounts of sugar with no fiber attached to it really overloads the pancreas and the liver and contributes to fatty liver and heart disease, as well as type 2 diabetes. So this is the meat of the issue, okay? It's not just about like, oh, you shouldn't have that because I'm just like, I want you to be this super cutesy, like, oh, I don't give my kids that. No, it's not about that. This isn't something to elevate yourself above others or anything like that. This is information that we all need to know just so we can make the best decision for our kids, okay? So when you think about that, you know, added sugar, what added sugar actually does when you're having too much without that fiber protein attached to it, it makes it very hard for the body to process it and send it to the places that it needs to go. So it ends up just sitting in your liver, contributing to fatty liver disease. And as you know, your liver is one of your body's cleaning systems. Okay. So if your liver isn't working right, then guess what? Less free radicals and other things are going to get filtered out of your blood and out of your lungs and all of those things. So again, this is why we're starting to see links between high sugar intake and asthma as well. So one thing definitely does affect the other in the body. So watching the sugar content for our little ones that are still developing is very, very, very important, okay? So again, you may say, all right, so what? It's got 12 grams of sugar, you know, per serving. So what, big deal? Okay, let's break it down again. A serving is one cup. So when we give our kids, according to this nutritional label, when we give our kids a serving of cereal, we're supposed to be giving them one cup of Cap'n Crunch or, you know, Fruit Loops or whatever. Now, whoever eats one cup of cereal, what is that going to do for somebody? That's not going to fill you up, right? So pause on that thought, right? So according to NIH, okay, the average American child eats about 2 to 3 cups of cereal in a sitting, means that they get about 24 to 36 grams of added sugar in a sitting as well. Now we're seeing what the problem is again. Okay, so first of all, they give you these small serving sizes on the nutritional packaging. So you're like, oh, per serving, and you forget that the serving ain't, they're not saying how much you just put in your bowl, no. So we having 2 to 3 servings at a time, and that's, you know, even my smallest child, you know, my baby, my smallest toddler, she can eat just as much cereal as I can eat at this point, okay? Girlfriend can throw down. So she's having at least 2 servings, and my older toddler is, you know, eating probably like me at least 2.5 to 3 cups, you know, because you want a big bowl of cereal to start your day, not eating again until lunch, you know. So that's a lot of sugar. So again, what's in that bowl? What's in the bowl? You know, we have to ask ourselves that question and really try to watch the sugar, okay? So now you're seeing that you're getting 2 to 3 times the grams of sugar. So you still might say, okay, well, so what? I'm getting, you know, 24 to 36 grams of sugar. How bad is that? Well, this is how bad it is, okay? According to NHH, and that's one of the European healthcare systems. And for certain things, I kind of like to like follow their guidelines a little bit, because certain things with the European standards versus some of the American standards as far as like sugar and nutrition goes, sometimes the European standard is just a little bit more realistic, I feel. So sometimes I follow that. So this statistic does come from there. But according to NHS, children ages 2 to 18 should have 25 grams of sugar per day. Okay, 25 grams of sugar per day. And remember, that's age 2 to 18. 25 grams a day. And we know as we become adults, we should start to like tightly, just a little bit decrease that. Okay. So again, you are giving them their whole daily allotment of sugar in the morning setting. And then what else do they eat through the day? Maybe they have some cookies with a whole bunch of added sugar. Maybe they have, you know, whatever they have, you know, maybe you feed them McDonald's. You know, I'm not one. We don't do McDonald's either in my house. So it all starts to add up is what I'm saying. Now, you don't need to start like counting everything that you do, because, you know, all those diets where it's like count these points, do this, do that. It becomes overwhelming. I believe the easiest thing to do is just make better choices that you can stick to all the time. So it's like, okay, if I'm not eating sugary cereals, then now I have my whole day where, you know, I can have a cookie, you know, maybe I can have a mixed drink or whatever else I want to have. And I'm not worried about, oh man, I had so much sugar this morning and I'm not overloading my system. Okay. So again, just have to be careful. So you see kind of the dangers of, you know, surpassing the daily allotment in one serving. You know, I'm really passionate about this because, you know, this is something that I see a lot. A lot of times you do want to do the best thing for your child, or, you know, maybe you're having a family member over, or maybe you're over at someone's home, or just maybe talking in the mom's group and this subject may come up, you know, oh, this is what I give my kid, or, you know, for breakfast or whatever. I remember one case that I've had several experiences like this, but one case I mentioned that I give my children, you know, plain cereal that does not have actually any sugar on it. And sometimes I'll just give them maybe just a little bit of almond milk mixed with some oat milk, you know, or pea protein milk. And you gotta let your kids be kids. That's ridiculous. You know, you gotta let your kids, you know, they gotta enjoy life. Let me tell you something, okay? That type of flawed decision-making, that irrational logic is the rhetoric of fools, okay? I'm just saying it like it is. It's the rhetoric of fools. If you're listening to this podcast, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you care about your child, because you wouldn't click on this if you didn't, okay? You want to know what's something good to do for your child. Don't let people's negativity, when you try to be different, when you don't want to eat the sugary cereals and do all these things, don't let it bring you down, okay? Because then, you know, that was said to me, and I'm like, oh, you know, you walk away feeling bad. And then I'm going, wait a minute. I'm trying to do something good. I love my child. That's why I don't give her those stuff. I want her to have a healthy, happy, productive life. Why would I knowingly give her these things? Why would I give them these things? You know, it's different if you don't know. But if you don't know, I do feel we just got to do the best that we can. And it's not easy. You know, the sugary stuff is more accessible. Sometimes, you know, the healthier stuff is more expensive. There's ways to work that, because I am a budget mom. I am not some Richie Poo, you know, mom like that can just go out and buy and do whatever. No, I have to definitely stick to budget. So I definitely understand that. But I'm here to tell you, if this is a lifestyle that you want to do and make these better choices in the morning with the cereals, it's absolutely possible, even if you are not, you know, a baller or whatever. Okay. So again, guys, really just have to think logically. And then I even had someone say to me, well, you know, apples, they have sugar too. okay, let me put that foul logic to rest as well, okay? Again, an apple is going to have some healthy fiber, okay? An apple is very, very fibrous. So you're talking about natural sugar, first of all. So this is naturally occurring sugar, not added refined sugar, okay? Naturally occurring sugar, our bodies are designed to process, okay? As a matter of fact, that apple was designed for our bodies to process it and break it down in the way it's supposed to. Now, there's a whole nother set of argument you can go on for. How safe are apple? How safe is fruit? That's a whole nother thing. That'll be another podcast and another video. But again, don't fall for that kind of foul rhetoric, because again, an apple with sugar is not the same as a sugary bowl of cereal, because first of all, an apple is super high in natural natural fiber, okay? Versus cereal has very little fiber in it, and it's also refined fiber, versus an apple is naturally occurring fiber and naturally occurring sugar. It's designed to work with our bodies. A bowl of cereal is a processed food that it's not, you know, it can be a good thing to eat if it's not loaded with sugar, but it's not naturally occurring, okay? So that's kind of the difference. An apple is also living, okay? It was like living at one point. It, you know, is a part of the photosynthesis process, and it takes in energy from the sun, and then that energy is absorbed by our bodies. A bowl of cereal is dead, okay? It is not the same as eating an apple. So don't let, again, people who are uneducated and people who don't really want to, you know, they want to excuse their bad behavior, and so much comes down to want, okay? They want to excuse their bad behavior. They feel bad when they see other people making better decisions with their health and dietary options than they are. And so instead of like either keeping quiet and minding their own business or saying something encouraging, they would rather put you down so that they feel better about themselves. Mommies, don't fall for it. Always do the right thing by your children, okay? So, you know, I really hope that this information is helpful for you guys. You know, I'm just kind of a tell it like it is person, and I really just want to help people. And there's tons of information out there on this stuff. You don't have to just take it from me. I always encourage people to go out there, get a good book, you know, stumble upon some reputable websites, and do some research yourself and figure out what will really work for you. But anyway, so today I did talk about, you know, some of those cereals that are not good to give our kids, okay? And just because it was not on this list doesn't mean that it is something you should give your kids to. So the point of it all is for you to start researching and seeing what is a good cereal and what isn't. And there's more horrible cereals out there than good, unfortunately. So again, empower yourself to go out there and figure out what's best for you. I am sorry if some of the information, sometimes it just gets overwhelming. You're like, man, all these cereals, and there's like one out of 10, you know, that might be good. I understand how that feels, because when you're trying to do the right thing as far as your kid's diet and you kind of just keep hitting these brick walls, it's very frustrating. So what I'm going to do too for another podcast and video is put out a list of good cereals. So I'll just kind of give you guys like 4 cereals that I like. And yeah, I think that hopefully will be helpful to everyone. So again, unfortunately, we live in a world where there is not a 100% perfect option. I really wish that there was. I have searched, trust me, but you're always going to have a little something off, even if you just give your kids straight oatmeal every day, which I highly recommend and is really good. But even that, you know, there is always like chemical content from like pesticides and things like that. That's going to be the case with everything. So you almost just have to kind of try to make the most balanced decision you can. And we almost kind of have to pick our poison, like which one is less poisoned, which one, you know, has the most nutritional value out of the options that I have available. So I feel like having a more balanced approach will help us all to be a lot less overwhelmed when we're trying to make these decisions. So I hope this information has been helpful to you. If you have any questions or anything you'd like to add to this, please drop me a line on maybe my Facebook comments or my YouTube comments. I love to hear from you guys. So thank you so much for listening to Work It Mommy. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next episode.